Nah.
Look, I don't know what you set up at the cabin, but it really made a difference.
I said what any guy would say. Look, step up and be a father, and no, I will not shoot you in the face.
Well, thanks. You know, I could have done worse than to have a father like you.
Yeah, I know. I met him.
Honey, where do we want Ryan's dad to sit?
As far away from me as possible.
Oh, hi. Listen, try to keep an open mind.
Ryan's dad, Canadian college professor, the jaws of life couldn't pry this nugget open.
Where's Ryan's mom gonna sit?
In Winnipeg. They're divorced.
Okie doke. Got a couple more RSVPs for Kristen's wedding.
Well, it's about time. We need to get a head count.
Yeah, well, so far, all 45 of Ryan's side have responded yes. Our side only has 16, so you do the math. Seriously, please don't make me do math.
This is terrible. We're getting beaten by the Canadians.
There's something you never hear outside of hockey.
Oh, and here are two more from our side.
Yes.
And they both say no.
No.
Although one of them would still like the chicken, if that's possible.
Our friends and relatives. We can't get these losers to drive 30 miles, but the Vogelsons, they're coming from every part of Canada, even the parts where they travel by dog.
Maybe you should save some of this for your wedding toast.
I'll get it. Honey?
I just wish he was different, you know?
We can't pick our fathers, you know? Lord knows I've tried. Used to send heartfelt letters to Mickey Mantle. Nothing.
All right, what do I do? Do I go back in there and give him another shot? Or...
It's your call, Ryan.
How old were you when you wrote letters to Mickey Mantle?
From about 10 until 31.
Hey, dinner's ready in 10.
Hey, come on here, sir.
Touch anything.
Right, and I don't like gum in there, too, but really, all right. When we're driving around, what do other people do when they see us?
They do this.
You know why they do that? This truck is older than you, but it's a classic, and people realize it's a classic. And you're a classic, too.
How flattering. I'm an old truck.
No, that's not what I meant. This is not an old truck. It was an old truck until I restored it. And why did I do that? Because I know cars, and I recognize its value.
Well, no one is recognizing mine, Mike.
But they will. Somebody who knows something about teaching is going to recognize your real value. I know this is going to happen.
It really is a beauty.
I prefer you don't touch it.
You know what? I am a classic, damn it.
That's right.
And the same thing that happened to this truck is going to happen to me.
That's right.
Yeah, I just have to get them to see my real value.
Bingo.
I mean, all this truck needed was some bodywork and some new paint.
Uh-huh.
And that's what I need.
Yeah. What's that name?
Yeah. I'm going to get plastic surgery.
No, let's reboot this conversation. No. Let's use the lawnmower as an example.
No,
low, greasy, and dirty.
I need to be restored. That is the only way I'm going to get to do what I love, teach.
Oh,
honey, you really are a genius.
Now I won't be able to take her out in the rain either.
You pull it out, you know.
Hey, Ed, I might need the service of a good plastic surgeon. Who's the doctor that made your third wife look a lot like your second wife?
You get a new face, Baxter? Because I could use a break from looking at this one.
Tappy, now that's the face of outdoor man. When people see that face, they want to buy stuff to kill something.
Well, thank you both. It's not for me, actually.
For Vanessa? Ah, well, congratulations. What's she bumping him up to?
You know, I'm gonna tell her you said that next time she goes on and on about what a classy guy you are.
What's up, Baxter? Vanessa doesn't need that kind of thing.
I know. She's got it in her head that if she wants to get back into teaching, she needs to be restored.
Restored? Where'd you get that crazy idea?
It beats me. Every interview she's been going on, she's losing out to young people.
That's not right.
Huh? No,
she's got something those young teachers don't have. Wisdom. If the price for that is a few wrinkles, so be it.
That's why nobody listens to a grape. And yet they'll sit at the feet of a raisin for hours.
Kale, a always talks about what an excellent teacher Vanessa was. I mean, she really pushed those kids and she never gave up on
them. She went in early, stayed late. Yeah. She really loved that job.
Yeah. And now with class sizes going up, a lot of them are falling through the cracks.
Isn't life strange, huh? Yeah. Vanessa wants to teach. Kids need teaching. Yet somehow you wind up paying for a boob job.
Looks like a raisin, thinks like a grape.
Still want that number?
No, I don't think I need it. Chuck, when you're done, stop by my office. I got an idea. Got the original top on it, one owner, and that was his dad.
And Chuck drove it in the snow? You gotta fire him.
We're firing someone? Let me do it, it's been a while. Who is it?
Chuck.
Chuck? What, are you heartless? The man just lost his father. We wait 2 weeks.
We're not firing anybody. His dad left. Apple. Listen, if.
Now, in my defense, you never called dibs.
I said I wanted the Corvair.
Yeah, but you gotta say dibs. Everybody knows, okay? The first rule of dibs is you gotta say dibs. That's why it's called dibs.
Do you realize you spit every time you say that? I love Corvairs. Why do you want this car?
I don't, but if I can buy it, do a little work on it, and sell it to somebody who does. You wanna buy a Corvair in 2 weeks?
You know, I kinda thought we were friends.
You called me a sneaky bastard.
You are a sneaky bastard.
What are we, 10 years old?
What are we, 10 years old? You're not getting that car, Joe.
Yes, I am. I'm buying that Corvair. If you want to buy it from me in 2 weeks, you got to call dibs.
You did it again. Just a little spittle went right here. With Santa Claus, or as I call it, the Museum of Crying.
Hey, can we talk about Christmas dinner? What do you guys think about having it at my house?
But honey, I'm the one who usually cooks for 2 days, then watches everything get wolfed down during halftime, and then cleans up by myself. Of course you can!
Great. With my new dining room set, I can fit all 9 of us at the table without anyone having to sit on Ryan's tribal drum.
9 of us? There's only 8 of us. Or do you guys count me twice because I eat both drumsticks?
No, I just thought... Of course, 8. Well, I'm terrible with numbers.
Says the girl who's in charge of payroll at the grill. I think she's talking about your secret boyfriend.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, give it up, Eve. Come on. You can't hide him forever like that snake you found in 3rd grade.
What snake?
All right, fine. His name is Rob. He's really nice. The boyfriend, not the snake. His name is Walter.
Why can't we meet him? We're nice. I mean, we are nice, damn it.
Eve, it has to happen sooner or later, okay? If there was a way not to meet Dad, trust me, Ryan would have found it.
Yeah. Rob's dating a Baxter daughter. He eventually has to face Baxter.
Why didn't you guys come here for brunch after church tomorrow?
Yeah, Rob doesn't eat. He's a scientific wonder. All right, fine, I'll ask him.
It's true. They shouted out his name in glee. It's a Christmas miracle.
Hey.
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 Hi.
Mrs. Baxter.
Hey. Doing the dishes.
Just the one dish?
Yeah, I'm done. Just the water glass, head water.
Mrs. Baxter, it's fine. Really. Look, I'd feel better if you just do whatever you would normally do.
Okay.
Damn, that looks good.
Oh, this is gonna be fun. I asked him to keep that a secret.
But so you are dating him?
You know what this situation reminds me of? Romeo and Juliet. Boring and I don't care.
There's nothing going on between me and Brandon. We meet at the driving range and he's teaching me how to hit golf balls.
Honey, why would you keep that a secret?
Because I didn't want Dad to know I'm practicing.
I don't have anything against you practicing. That's how you get better at stuff. Your mom doesn't practice lying, and look how bad she is at it.
All right, Dad, you don't want me to get better at golf. You just expect me to be instantly awesome at everything. Football, soccer, shooting.
That is not true.
It is. You don't realize it, but it's a lot of pressure being your son. Let's go, Logan.
Nice to meet all of you.
That's good, because I have a secret plan.
What are you talking about?
Well, I can't tell you because it's Mike's secret plan.
Hey, Chuck. Oh, hey, Vanessa. Hi. I'm so surprised to see you here. I did not expect it. But since you are here, why don't you come with Mike and me to the conference room? This is a funny coincidence.